Hi, my name is Bridget Hurst, and my research question is, how does playing competitive sports affect women's mental health in the United States? It is important for society to remember that competitive sports teaches female athletes with the goals of identifying traits and behaviors that are particularly adaptive to help benefit female athletes' mental health in the setting of sports. What female athletes have benefited from in sports. Competitive sports teaches female athletes the skill of time management. It helps increase their motivation to do their schoolwork and get better grades. It has been proven that sports gives you a boost of popularity at school. Participating in sports decreases depression on student athletes. Time management will teach female athletes ways to manage participating in several different activities without putting a lot of stress on them. Time management is one of the most important lessons athletes are taught through sports. It is the way female athletes learn to organize and plan how much time they should spend on specific activities such as sports. This creates greater productivity and efficiency. The article, Sports Benefit Girls in Many Ways, states, playing sports adds to, not detracts from, a girl's time, energy, and commitment to schoolwork. The co-founder and CEO of EDU Sports states, there are many research findings which highlight that children dabbling with both sports and academics are better focused as discipline, concentration, and time management. Learned through sports come in handy. Being motivated to do schoolwork decreases dropout rates for female students in high school. An example of this is in the state of Florida, you need a minimum of a 2.0 GPA to be able to participate in school athletics, which boosts several female athletes' motivation to do better in school. This also helps prove the idea that competitive sports increases women's motivation to play sports throughout college. It is a student's choice to play sports in school, which makes it their choice whether or not they want to do good in school. Being able to play sports is an award on female athletes, and they have to earn their right to play sports. The head coach of Seattle Seahawks, Pete Carroll, states, what it takes to make a touchdown, all the hard work, all the practice, and the dedication, is as valuable off the field as on. The popularity at school creates good social skills for female student athletes to develop for their future. Another quote from the Sports Benefit Girls in Many Ways states, like male athletes, today female athletes are more popular. Sports can gain girls entry into often complex social hierarchies of high school. This chart from the Women's Sports Foundation shows that from the past fall, women who did not participate in sports had far more depression. Some of the negative impacts competitive sports have on women is the inequality women have to face and how it impacts their mental health. The article, Tackling Wider Inequalities, Empowering Women Through Sport, states, the world of sport remains plagued by many of the same gender inequalities that we see more broadly. Issues such as unequal pay, gender-based violence, a lack of targeted investment, and negative stereotypes in social norms. The chart to the right shows that women are significantly underrepresented in higher paid senior level roles. Serena Williams is a great example of female inequalities that female athletes face on an everyday basis. Serena Williams is an African American female athlete, and she has to live with two inequalities throughout her everyday life, from racism to sexism. Listening to the hatred comments people say about her can have a negative impact on her mental health. However, she has not let the hatred stop her. Serena has put all of her time and energy to show how good she can be at tennis and works even harder to improve her skills. And all of her hard work has paid off. She became one of the first African-American women to win the Grand Slam singles. The text, the meaning of Serena Williams states, to accept itself, its humanity, is to discard the white racist gaze. Serena has freed herself from it. Nevertheless, that does not mean she will not be emotional or hurt by the challenges to humanity. It does not mean she won't battle for the right to be excellent. Thank you.
All right, I have two questions for you. What evidence did you gather that you didn't use, and then why did you choose not to use it?
The evidence I gathered was like opinions from male athletes, and they were pretty biased because they weren't like researched. It was just what they noticed in female athletes. So I chose not to use it because of the bias.
Okay, and if you had more time, what additional research would you conduct related to this issue?
Additional research I would have done is figure out different ways the researchers like use their research and how like the different techniques they used to see how it would impact their research.